Now we will study how to calculate number of atoms in a unit cell. So today we will study to calculate number of atoms in a unit cell. As we have studied, we have primitive unit cell. In a primitive cubic unit cell, only atoms are present at corner. Atoms are only present at corners. So before we start the calculation of number of atoms in a unit cell, let us understand one atom contribute what amount of its portion in a one unit cell. Let's begin with the one cube, which is shown over here. You can easily see a cube over here, where let's say this is a crystal. This is a crystal, a cubic crystal, where on eight corners we have eight atoms. You can see it is divided into eight unit cells. The center one, the atom which is present over the center, it is covering, you can easily see this portion. This is the portion of one unit cell only. The unit cell which is going to contribute is only this portion. Okay. So whole atom at a corner can adjust, it is adjacent with the another eight unit cells. You can see this is one unit, this is to another unit cell, this is another unit cell, this is the another unit cell, the back side, front side, means top on the four and the below on the four. So there are eight unit cells come together to form a one cube, where we have to understand if one unit cell, one atom is shared by, one atom present at a corner is shared by eight unit cells, then one unit cell contain what portion of atom. Easily we can understand that it is 1/8. How? Let us see. At corner the contribution of atom in unit cell, as we have seen in the figure here. Okay, what we have seen, we have seen that one atom present over here is shared by eight unit cells. So how many unit cells do I have right now? I have eight unit cells. Okay, and how many atoms do I have? The eight unit cells sharing one atom at corner. So if I am going to take one unit cell, what will be the contribution? Answer is but obvious, we can have 1/8. So this is the contribution of atom in a one unit cell at corner. Are we clear? So we have to make it very clear in our mind that at a corner in one unit cell, contribution of atom is 1/8. Now let's see, when an atom is present at a face centered, this is to explain you, this figure has been drawn. This is a cube where I have shown you a face. It has also like this. When I have a face, what exactly happen? I can cut a one ball from two part. So half will be on this side and half will be on this side. This is one plane. Let's say this is the one plane which I'm going to show it by the lines over here. This is the end atom at a center. So when I cut that atom with the help of this plane, half portion will be on this side, half portion will be on this side. So at face center contribution of atom in unit cell. Now let us see how many unit cells are connected with it. this is one unit cell and this is another unit cell. So by applying a unitary method, let's see, unit cell and atom. If I have two unit cells shared by one at face center, then if I have one, what will be the contribution? Answer is 1/2. So this is the contribution at face center. Half is the contribution of atom at a face center. So two things we have to keep it in our mind. One, what is the contribution of atom at corners is 1/8 in a one unit cell. And what is the contribution of atom at a face center in a one unit cell is half. One more is there, which we'll talk later on of it. But let's see now the last and the final. When an atom is there at a body center, yesterday we have discussed about a body centered cubic cell. So when an atom is present in a body centered, then in a one unit cell, the contribution of body at body center, at a body center, contribution of atom in unit cell is 1. Yes, this is what we have to understand. Why? Because only one atom you can see easily. It is covered by the all atom. This is called a BCC, which we called it as a body centered cubic unit cell. So these are the three things which we have to understand, that at the corner what we have understand. Let us recall here. One, at corner the contribution is 1/8 of atom. Second, at face center the contribution is half. And third, at body center it is 1. Okay, so are we clear with the help of this thing? That's very clear about that. Okay, at a corner the contribution of one atom in a unit cell is 1/8, at a face center is half, and at a body center it is 1. Now let's begin with the calculation of number of atoms present in a unit cell. Now we will study how to calculate number of atoms in a unit cell. We have a three types of unit cell. The first one which we talk about is a primitive cubic unit cell. Primitive cubic unit cell. So in a primitive cubic unit cell, atoms are only present at a corner. Atoms are only present at a corner. What does they have? They have a such kind of structure which I'm going to draw here. We can see this is a simple cube. This is a simple cube. And there are 8 corners which already we have discussed. And atoms present over are here. Okay. So in a one unit cell, I know only 1/8 portion of atom is contributed. So how many atom must be present over there? Let us understand. Okay, at corner, how many atoms are there? At corner, there are 8 atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. What is the contribution of it? It's 1/8. So if I calculate, do we have another atom in any place other than that? No. In a primitive unit cubic unit cell, we don't have. It means that the answer will be 1. The answer will be 1. So number of atoms present in simple cubic unit cell is equal to 1. Number of atom present in simple cubic unit cell is 1. This is the first portion. Now let's talk about second unit cell, which we called a body centered unit cell. Let us see with the help of another pen. is it yeah body centered cubic unit cell, cubic unit cell. So let's draw. How does it look like? It's very simple, both easily you can make it out. Okay, this is a body centered cubic cell. Very simple one. First you have to draw a cube, which I'm going to mention over here. This is what we have, a cube. All the 8 atoms are present over here. This 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8, and at the center. Now let us calculate how many atoms are there in a one body centered cubic unit cell. So at corner, how many atoms do we have? Same, this one going to remain same, 8. Contribution of one atom in a one unit cell at a corner is 1/8. So 8/8, 1/8, answer is 1. Now at body centered, how many atom do we have? One. We have one atom. And what is the contribution in the previous section? In the section we have talked about, it's 1. So 1:1. So total number of atoms. Total atoms. What will be the total atoms? Let us see. The total atom will be 1 + 1, 2. So in a body centered cubic unit cell, we have 2 atoms present over there. So if you have a one simple body centered cubic unit cell, you have to consider that it has 2 atoms present over there. And now the final one, the third one, which is very very important for us, that is face centered cubic unit cell. This is a face centered cubic unit cell. Let us draw a diagram over here. I'm going to make it out over here, but let's see how can I make it out clear figure over here. So this is one cube which we are going to draw as usual. A simple cube can be drawn. How many atoms do we have at a corner? Yes, they are 8. They are 8 atoms. So I'm going to make it 8 atoms on the corner. It is compulsory to make this diagram for your understanding. Once you will go through and well versed with it, then there will be no need of it. Now let's see, we have a 6 faces. So one face, this face which I'm going to talk about, this here one atom, opposite side face here one atom. You can see, you can relate with your room where we are sitting, where we have 4 walls and one ceiling and one floor. So 2 sides wall, where right side wall and left side wall, then in front side wall and back side wall. But before, let's see, that's a ceiling. This is one atom at the ceiling center. There is one atom at the floor. Now one is on the back side, in the front of you, where you are facing on that wall, and the one atom is on the this side. So total, how many atoms do we have in the face one? We have 6 atoms present over there. So let us see, now calculate that. How can we calculate number of atoms in that at corner? Very simple. Now you can easily make it out. 8 atoms are there, multiply by 1/8. Why we are multiplying by 1/8? Because the contribution of atom at a corner is 1/8, and that's why the answer will be 1. At face centered, at a face centered, how many atoms do we have at a face center? So at a face center we have 6 faces, and that's why there are 6, and the contribution of each atom is 1/2 at a face center, and that's why the answer will be 3. So what will be the total number of atoms atoms is equals to 3 plus 1 4. So we come to know at the end of this section we have learned. So we have studied that primitive unit cell at a corner 8 by 8 into 1 by 8 1. So number of atom present in a 1 simple cubic unit cell is 1. Body centered unit cell at a corner 8 into 1 by 8 is equals to 1. At a body center 1 into 1 is equals to 1. So total number of atoms will be 2. Face centered cubic cell, as we know there are 8 atoms at a corner, so the contribution will be 1. But at a face there are 6 faces and the atoms are 6, but the contribution of face atoms at a face centered is 1 by 2. That's why 6 into 1 by 2 is equal to 3, and that's answer is 4. So in a simple unit cell, in simple cubic unit cell, atom is 1. Number of atom present in a 1 unit cell is 1. Number of atom present in 1 unit cell in a body centered cubic cell is 2, and number of atoms present in a face centered cubic cell is 4.